YouTube channel. It's your girl Sid. I am back with another video. I'm just clocking out of work, so please excuse how I look. I know I look a mess, and I keep saying I'm gonna get me a new phone holder so that y'all are not like behind my steering wheel, but whatever. We're gonna figure it out. But like I said, I'm just clocking out of work, and but let me recap my weekend with you guys. So over the weekend, I went to a Ty Tripper concert with some of my girls, and when I tell you that concert, the only one night though tour, if he's coming near you, you need to be in the room. Like, he set that place on fire. The Holy Spirit had his way, like messed up his whole set as it relates to the flow of it. So we just flowed with the Lord, and it was just so good. It was so needed. But in that atmosphere, right, the Lord began to deal with me about some things, that how I was portraying him. He was sharing how I was misrepresenting him when it came to someone who's a non-believer, and how I threw like this arrogance about myself of how I am this new person, I'm transformed, this and the third. But the way that he put it to me is if I was, he said it, he reminded me that I had this like Pharisee mentality about it, as if I was boasting, as if I did it. Like, if you think about it, the Pharisees in the Bible believed that they were it. They were the end all be all. They were the keepers of the law. They lived and abide and breathed the law. But Christ said, I came to fulfill the law. The law has already been fulfilled. So you don't even have to think in that mindset, like, I've already done. The work is complete. All you have to do is walk in it. And he just reminded me, like, to not walk in that spirit of pride, filling yourself up and all of this. So the way that I said it, so while I was in worship, he had like convicted my heart, and I was like, Lord, I did not mean to, you know, portray it that way. I did not mean to come off as this arrogant Christian. Like, sometimes the way you present God can be a turn off to other people. And so it's not that we need to have this, help me Holy Spirit, like this arrogance about us that, you know, well, I know Christ and you don't, or my life is transformed and yours not. Like you won't just on your bedroom floor weeping like you wanted to give it all up. Like, hello, like, I still struggle, but also, like, he found me in my dark, you know, in my darkest place. And so that's where he wants to meet us. Like, the thing about Jesus is he made himself low in order to reach the people who were lost. Like, he came down to where people were, not to say that he joined them in their sin, or he met them where they were. And my pastor said something that really struck a nerve with me. He said that Christ didn't only just meet the spiritual needs of those he had, you know, he had preached to and who he had opened the door to show him what, you know, to follow me. He also met physical needs. That's so good. And my pastor was saying how sometimes when you meet a physical need, it opens the door for the spirit, because you know the spirit and the physical realm mimic or mirror, I should say, not mimic, but mirror one another. And so what happens in the physical sometimes first takes place in the spirit, and sometimes what we do in the physical ignites something in the spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And so when he said that, it made so much more sense of how I've been operating, and it just gave me a new perspective of how to share Christ, even with those who, one, don't know him, but also in the way that I share with those who are closest to me and those who are around me, like meeting their physical needs. Because it made me just think of just now how when he had found Peter, first he asked to use his boat. When Peter first had the encounter with Jesus, he was out fishing, but he had fished all night and he literally didn't catch anything. And so the Holy Spirit just reminded me that he used Peter's boat, and then he told Peter, cast your nets, to go back out and cast it. He's like, Lord, I've been fishing all night. And at this point, I think he had not yet paid his debt. I think Peter was still in a lot of debt, and he was trying to cover his debt. And what the Lord did for him, or what Christ did for him, is that he said, go do it again. So he went back out and he cast his net, and he caught so many that his boat began to overflow. So he met Peter's physical need in order to capture him spiritually. So that was so powerful to me. So all this weekend has just been ministering to where I am. I was just sitting in the car right before I pressed record, because I'm in this space, and I keep telling the Lord about this, of how I'm in such this space of where I'm I keep saying, I'm ready, Lord. I'm ready to be full ministry. I'm ready to be full entrepreneur. I'm ready. And, you know, I was sitting at work and I'm like trying to be present. And I have been present, but I'm having to remind myself, do everything as if you're doing it unto the Lord. Because, y'all, when I tell you, the struggle has been all the way real when it comes to being at a place where you know that in between, like, I know within me that God is calling me out of my job, but has not yet gave me the okay to leave my job. Like, I know, but it's like this prep, but almost at the finish line type deal. And I'm like, Lord, I'm about to start sweating. I'm like, Lord, get me out of here. Like, I'm ready. And I keep saying I'm ready, but I'm still, I wish I can explain it. So I'm just trying to be patient. Be patient with myself. Be patient with where God has me and what he's doing. Because I don't know. I don't know all. And I don't know all the time what God is doing. But he's really been having me to change my language. That was one thing that Ty Trippett said. He was like, you know, we can look at a situation and we can, he said, we build the muscle of whatever we speak. So if we're saying that this is what we're going to be like always, we just build that thing stronger. But when we begin to speak the word becomes stronger. It says, oh, magnify the Lord with me and exalt his name forever. So magnify, make bigger the word of God, and everything else will seem like it's minute. And that's what I've been trying to, you know, really telling myself in this season, to magnify the Lord and to make everything else so minute. Because just think about it, it really is a piece of cake for God. But we make it so hard when we wrestle with the fact that we feel like we have to take it on. And that's what I was really sharing with God. You know, my pastor also went to the scripture in 1 Colossians 3:17, where it talks about, it is not important who plants, it is not important who waters, it is only God who provides the increase. And, you know, sometimes it's hard when we are trying to win somebody over to Christ. We feel like we have to do it all. We feel like we have to plant, pluck, water, uproot, weed, all that. When God said plant the seeds or water it, if it's you who was coming behind somebody else and watering that thing, God is the one who is in charge of the increase, no matter what, whether you are trying to win someone over to Christ or not even win, because Christ already won. So it's their choice. It's ultimately their choice. Like, I was feeling so defeated because I'm like, Lord, I'm trying to win over this person. I'm trying to, because I know this is what you said. You know what I'm saying? You put so much weight and so much pressure on yourself. And that's what I was doing. So I was cracking under pressure. I was really cracking under pressure. And I know God saw that. Like, I just was carrying the weight of the world. And in that, because I felt like my works, thank you, Holy Spirit, was not working. And what I was doing was not working. I was getting frustrated. So I stepped out of love. I stepped out of peace. I stepped out of grace, and I began to operate in strictly flesh. So all weekend, a couple days, I was just operating out of flesh. I'm like, you know what, Lord, I'm just not going to do nothing. I'm not going to do it. I'm not seeing it. But I noticed that on my wall, I have this mural or this sticker that I got, you know, those like wall stickers, and it says, with God all things are possible. But right now I have like some decor that's hanging up, like a couple hats that are hanging up in the middle bedroom, and it's covering up with God, but it just says possible. Like, I felt like God was really using that to stand out to me, like, change your language, instead of saying like, Lord, this is too hard, like, possible. Say it's possible, because it is. If all things are possible with God, all things are possible to them that believe. And if you believe, huh? Oh, what does the scripture say? But he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. So if you're seeking God, and you're diligent about how you seek him, and if you are one of those who the fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much, just know that God will reward you for seeking him. Jesus. So even if you feel like what you're doing is not producing the result that you think, regardless if it's like business wise, or if you're ministering to someone and you feel like it's not even getting through, like I just felt like nothing was penetrating. Whatever I was saying, whatever I was doing, I just felt like nothing was penetrating. And that was such a great reminder that it is not important who plants. It is not important who waters. What is important is God is the one who makes it grow. That's what he said. He makes the seeds grow, or he is the one who provides the increase. So remember that when you're at work. Remember that when you are in the building stage. Remember that when you are waiting on God to produce something in your life that he promised. Just know if he said it, he's going to do it. And I'm talking to myself. If he said it, he's going to do it 100%. He's not going to leave you. He's not going to leave you hanging. That's one thing God will not do. But when we stop, is when we stop and just stop believing altogether. It's not that God left us hanging. We stop working. God can only work when we work. We have to be active participants in this thing called life. We have to be active participants in his will. We have to be active participants in everything that he is calling us to do. And when you stop, you're allowing life and defeat to win. When God says, wow, we win together. We win together. Wow. Oh my gosh, there's one bulletin board that just reminded me. It says, when you win, we win. When you win, we win. So our wins, our losses, God takes them all as his own. Like he, man, it's so good. But yeah, I'm about to hop out this car. I got like 10-15 minutes to go upstairs, grab me some lunch, and head back out the door to get Joe from school. This was just a quick video. I just wanted to check in with you guys, give you guys a little recap. If this has blessed you, impacted you any kind of way, make sure you like, share, subscribe. And if you have not got a chance already, check the link in my bio for the upcoming course that I'm releasing. It's called Uncovering Patterns at Prophesy. I'm so excited about this course and what the Lord is going to do through it, the transformation that is going to take place in the lives of women, the transformation that's going to take place to change the trajectory of how you see God, how you view God, and in turn your life will be changed as a result. So if you get a chance, check out that. I have a free preview if you click the link below, and I'll get that to you. But y'all be blessed, and I will catch you guys on the next video. Bye.